concrete bad guys, not what is wrong with the system itself. This overload of vulgar anti-capitalist criticism is just one side of the global phenomenon. Its other side is different attempts to what we may call the postmodern ethical capitalism. The idea is, and it's again quite honorable idea, I'm not a priori opposed to it. The idea is that one can render the ecological and social responsibility profitable. As they like to put it in their New Age terminology, the partisans of this orientation, that this idea of, on the one hand, sleazy private capitalists amassing profit, on the other hand, those who care for the global good, there is still the old paradigm, no? That in the new emerging paradigm, the two dimensions can go together. Again, up to a point they can, but up to a point. Maybe you know this movement, again, nothing bad about it, I only think it has limits. I'm referring her to the movement of so-called natural capitalism, instigated by Peter Hawking. What they propose is a kind of new revolution in production, comparable to the first industrial revolution, which, as we all know, generated a breathtaking material development, but at an immense cost to the earth. Depletion of natural wealth, loss of the topsoil, destruction of species, and so on and so on. In order to counteract this destructive tendency, we have to change our entire approach. Till now, we included into the price of commodities only what we have to invest to produce them, ignoring the costs to nature. Our prosperity was thus illusory, since, by way of ruthlessly exploiting natural resources, we were drawing our income not from earnings but from principal, from inherited wealth. The sum of this inherited wealth is natural capital. The store of commodities produced by nature in the billions of years of its development. Commodities like water, minerals, trees, soil, air, plus all living systems, grasslands, forests, oceans, and so on. All these living systems not only supply non-renewable resources for our material production, they also render services indispensable for our survival. Regeneration of atmosphere, soil, fertilization, and so on. So, here is the proposal. To our standard notion of capital as store value, we should add the economic value of nature as a system, as well as the value of human resources. We thus obtain four forms of capital: financial capital, investments, monetary instruments, manufactured capital, machines, the entire infrastructure, natural capital, resources, living systems, and human capital, labor, intelligence, culture, organization. Admitting the difficulty of assigning monetary value to, for the time being at least, non-substituable services like the oxygen production by plants, natural capitalists nonetheless risk estimates according to which, for example, the worldwide oxygen production is worth $36 trillion annually, and as they like to point out, more or less the same as the gross world product. Or they claim the monetary value of all human capital is three times greater than all financial and manufactured capital. So the idea of natural capitalism is to change radically our accountancy by way of treating as the capital which should be enriched through its expanded reproduction all the four components, not only the first two. This can be done, they claim, Peter Hawking and his colleagues, in four main ways. First, radical resource productivity, promoting industrial efficiency and so on. Second point, biomimicry, eliminating waste by redesigning industrial systems on biological lines. Three, a service and flow economy. shifting from a perception of wealth as goods and purchases to a perception of value as desired services and satisfaction of human needs. And last, when investing in natural capital, developing markets for activities which enhance and restore our environment. So that's their position. I hope it was at least clear. This is the position I was describing, not my position. Why? Because you know that something quite comical is happening, if you allow me a brief 2 minute tour, which makes me a little bit depressed. What that guy Adam Pierce, who attacked me 2 years ago in New Republic, started is now circulating in France, in already 3 German newspapers, and so on. Namely, they quote a passage from my In Defense of Lost Causes, where I clearly, unambiguously, describing a position which, of course, is not mine. The position of what Jean-Claude Miller, in his very weird book called Criminal Tendencies of Modern Europe, his thesis is that European Union is, he directly claims this, I'm not like extrapolating it, that European Union is a continuation of Hitler with other means. And this is why the only solution for Europe is to eliminate the Jews. It's still, I mean, Miner doesn't claim this, he is a Zionist. He claims that this is the reality of Europe. I describe this position. And it's incredible. Again and again, this is quoted as a proof that I am a radical anti-Semite advising mass killing of all Jews. And it's incredible how I tried to write to newspapers in Germany, the last one was Die Zeit, I think, which published this, a letter where I explained unambiguously that I'm describing another guy's position. The answer I got was a very brutal irony that now I'm trying to squeeze out by claiming that I didn't quite mean what I wrote there and so on. It's really strange times, but sorry for this. So now comes my opinion. On the first approach, it may appear that such a radical redefinition of capital has beneficial effects. And undoubtedly it has them. Of course, you have to change all strategy. Why not? I think there are nonetheless first, unsurmountable empirical problems here. If this redefinition is to become even minimally operative, it would demand an incredibly complex worldwide state control and regulation. Like some state or whatever agency must determine the price of natural commodities and then must enforce them onto the market, and so on. So, what I'm saying is that although Peter, this is the first contradiction I see, and it's a typical contradiction, I had a nice public fight, a friendly one, but nonetheless it was shouting, but friendly shouting, with Tony Negri, also, but you had it in Berlin, where my basic problem with Negri developed, again, his notion of multitude, claiming that that's the new positive productivity, the new political subjectivity, and you know, he then exploded in his ecstatic dream. Can't we see communism is practically here? Capitalists are purely parasitic, we just have to cut them off and we are there. One step from communism. I told him that, doesn't he see that, all examples that he gives of multitude, I hope you would agree at least here with me, strictly presuppose not only a minimal law and order, but even a very strong state guaranteeing many things. And point two, that all the most convincing examples that he gives of multitude are examples within capitalism. So that I simply see no foundation in what he describes of how to pull this miracle to cut off the capitalists and to generalize the model of multitude to the entire society. So then he told me you don't understand anything because you are a Hegelian. Okay, maybe.